Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Belmont Bruins and the Duke Blue Devils.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Blue Devils are not facing one of their tougher opponents, so what's the key in them not giving it away?
Well, for me, the keys are these. First, reward your big man for working hard down low. Get him the ball, baby. If he has position, get the rock to him immediately. Second of all, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one. And finally, make your team think defense first. Solid defense will lead to good offense.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Now they'll bring it up. Intercepted. That's picked off.
Hey, kid's got great defensive court sense.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. He's got an open look for the shot.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
Perfectly executed. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. He looks at the hoop. The power forward takes the feed.
Great play to take the basket.
They work it around the perimeter. 5 second call approaching. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Looking for a good shot. Number 21 is eager and excited to compete.
Well, he's had some success and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
Now trying to feed the low block.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
And the slam.
Up, up, and away. Slam jam there. What muscle he's got, baby.
Moving it around the perimeter. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Way off target. Down inside. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Goes up for two. And he missed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Scorches the net.
Definitely worth another look, Brad. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. They go into the low block. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Nicky Sibley on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Trying to feed the low block. Number 21 is getting some love from the crowd now.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it.
With the fake.
Double team now, bad angle.
Oh, what a strip, Brad. Gave it up. The center with the ball. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player.
With a rejection. Transition opportunity coming up. I'll tell you what, with a score, this crowd is going to go nuts, Dick. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
The power forward takes the pass. Leans in. Can't get the shot to drop. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. On the dribble, gives it up. He gets the rejection. Off the rim and no good.
Dump it inside.
He unloads a three.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
He shoots from outside. Way off target. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrew. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. Off the rim and no good. Number 21 is animated and ready to go.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
He puts up the three ball. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Controlling the ball.
Look at that spacing.
Unloads a three. Can't seem to find the stroke from the arc, Dick.
And they're missing wide open looks too, Brad. My goodness, Mr. Nesler, that was phenomenal, baby!
The Blue Devils have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
Keep your eye right on the ball here.
Side.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
The power forward gets the pass. Number 12, pump fakes. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Entry pass in the paint. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The skip pass is picked off. Gave it up. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Working around the perimeter. This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Pull-up jumper from way out.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Way off target. The point guard gets the ball. Dickie's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, laying in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Working around the perimeter. Looking for a good shot. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
From center court. And it's no good from three-point range. At the end of the first half, the Bruins are down by four. Duke is making good use of the three ball here, Dick.
Absolutely, Brad. So far, at least 50% of their scoring output comes from behind the arc. When you're burying them from the three like that, you can second-guess the defense by taking the ball to the hole.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Dumps it in. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
Great anticipation defensively.
The point guard receives the ball. He faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
And the fans are going wild.
It's electrifying in here.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
The shooting guard handles the pass. Off the rim and no good. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Done a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
And it's blocked. The ball goes out of play. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
The power forward receives the pass. With a jump hook, in and out. The point guard handles the feed. Moving it around the perimeter. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
The fans start to chant.
Well, ultimately, the goal is to win. The crowd feels as though they are a big part of it, too.
He throws up the shot. Nice shot. They come with a double team to stop it. Tries one from three-point land. Rims out. They'll work it around the arc. Now they work it around the perimeter.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. And a momentary look from three-point land. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Kicks it out. He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Picked off. He looks for the bomb. That was nice.
This is simply a great play, Brad.
He's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Goes up for two. There was no doubt about that one. For the bucket. Doesn't go. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He lets it go. Way off target. Like usual, there's a sea of blue in the bleachers.
In some cases, Brad, if you're not wearing their color, they'll politely ask you to leave the section.
He takes it away.
You really need to protect the ball around these guys.
Takes away the pass. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
On the dribble, gives it up. Picks off the lazy pass. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
They're working around the perimeter. Entry pass in the paint. Number 23 is pounded on his way up. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, a sense of urgency down here on the bench. The coaching staff is starting to sense their players are starting to panic, and they want that stopped before any further damage is done. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. Misses the second shot.
Take that basketball with that good defensive rebound. Then I've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Look at that spacing.
He rejects it. He fakes the shot. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Toronto fadeaway. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there that...
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick T.O., baby. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Nothing but joy and delight in the stands right now. These fans realize that this game is out of reach, Dick.
That's what the fans came to see. Their team win. 5 points, 10 points, 20 points, it doesn't matter.
Gave it up. He gives him the fake. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important.
Blocks the shot. They run it up into transition. Number 24 is called for the foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Number 55 walks out to get his first minutes tonight.
They have such a deep bench, Brad. This kid could start for any program in the land.
Except this one, apparently.
Well, you never know what the story really is.
Second shot is no good. They work it around the perimeter. In the paint. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Tries for two. Puts it up, looking for contact. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Wide open for the shot. The fake.
Got to take some pride on a defensive end.
Top of the circle. Not there.
Dump it inside.
Takes the outside jumper. He nails the bucket.
This is what posters are made from.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Rims out. Shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
On the dribble, gives it up.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
They're working around the arc on the outside. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
The Blue Devils have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
A high screen. 10 on the shot clock. Shot clock is dead. He unloads a three. Off the rim and no good.
Look at that spacing.
Looking for a good shot. Got the high pick. Working it around the perimeter. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Blue Devils is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.